Yeah, you're looking over him. I mean, that's a no-brainer to fight Pacquiao. Right. Like, he's a future Hall of Famer. You know, he broke all these records. You know, he's a humongous draw. He's getting older, so he has a few fights left in him. You know, no telling who he might fight, and they might, you know, retire. So.
Is that a passing of the torch, you think, if you can get that fight?
Well, I don't really think it's a passing of a torch, but it is, you know, a huge, you know,
resume builder.
Resume and, you know, crossover fight. Because Pacquiao is a really big name. He's a crossover fighter. He's a, you know, icon in the sport. So just to get that fight with him and beat him, you know, that kind of would be a passing of a torch, so to say, in a sense.
Yeah. Some feel from this one southpaw to another. For both of y'all.
Huh?
Some feel this is a crossover fight for both you and Mikey.
Oh, definitely. I mean, this is major for Mikey. Like, you know, he's breaking records too. And they being like five fighters or six fighters to, you know, win I think in like five divisions or something like that, six. So, I mean, just for him to do that and, you know, cross over and become, you know, that huge name, and then, you know, he easily had great fights at, you know, 35, Lomachenko and other fights. So, you know, his playing field is huge with him can move down to 35, 40 and fight somebody at 47. So, I mean, it's definitely a crossover.
He's the one who said, he says he's more comfortable at 135. How do you feel about Mikey being the one to step up and call you out when all the other champs, like you said, they don't want to fight?
I'm going to just show you he's a real fighter. He's a true fighter. And, you know, it's kind of like a double-edged sword because it shows that he's a real fighter, he's a true fighter, but, you know, it could be, you know, with me knocking him out in the first round, they're going to say he was too small. You know, me beating, just punishing him throughout the whole fight, they're going to say it was a size band, a size difference, and things like that. And he's still earning his highest career payday, and he can go down and fight for his belt at 35 and 40 anyway. So I just feel like, you know, it's really a win-win for him too, and he's getting more notoriety too.